Everyone for being here. We're here to discuss the logo refresh. I want to go a little bit into why logos exist, a little bit of the history, a little bit of the process and how we got to this point, and then a little bit about what the potential refresh provides. And then if adopted, just very briefly touch on how it would be implemented, because I know that certain things like costs are a big concern for members of the public as well. So with that, it's a few minutes past five, and let's get started. So I want to thank you all for being here today, but I want to start off a little bit about the purpose or the elements of a good logo. A good logo is meant to capture attention, it's meant to make an impression, and it's meant to be memorable. And good logos need to be simple, relevant, either relevant to the time, relevant to who you're trying to reach, or relevant to what you're trying to say. They need to be memorable. You need to, always be able to recognize that symbol is Pepsi, even though it may have changed a dozen times in the last 50 years. You still know that symbol is that particular product. And you can recognize it easily when you go down the aisles. You want it to be timeless. It's probably the hardest one of the goals or the pillars of a good logo to achieve, timelessness. Red Cross is a very timeless symbol, but even that had to be changed dependent upon the location where they were at, whether it was Red Cross or now Red Crescent. It needs to be versatile. Means it needs to be able to be used anything from big to small and on a variety of platforms or items, whatever it is that you're trying to put out there to the public. It needs to translate well across the board. So a little history of the city logo. Well, we have the state of Minnesota seal, and prior to 1977, at least officially, the city seal or logo was basically a rehash of the state seal. I don't know if there's a whole lot to say about that right now at this point. But the logo that we currently have, it was created by Marv Wangen. I hope I said that correctly. Wangen? Wangen, excuse me. I knew I was going to say it wrong. Okay, Wangen, thank you. Is counselor and mayor, professional graphic artist, owner of advertising firm. This logo was adopted in 77. Now, it was starting to get used, or ideas for the logo were being created in 75, and they were just working at it and eventually adopted in 77. But even in his own statement, Mr. Marv Wangen had said that the triangle can also be seen as a sailboat, which I think a lot of people see when they look at that. And we'll get into that as to relevance and everything else. But our path to this point, I guess it could say it started with the water tower. In 2021, we requested a number of artists to give us their proposals or their ideas for the water tower. There was always the option of just doing the logo like we've done on other ones, or should we do something different? That process was very similar to the process of this logo that you found out you can not really find consensus, but a lot of what was created was very hard to translate onto the water tower. Was not very versatile for that particular medium, for that particular purpose. And like I said, we then said, well, why not the logo? Then the question came up, well, do we want to change the logo? Because I know that had been something that the former mayor, more recent mayor, Vern Rasmussen, had suggested on a number of occasions. So it got us thinking and it got us discussing it. We spent a little money, hired a marketing firm to go over whole new concepts or refresh logo. Through that, we talked about color schemes, we talked about fonts, we talked about slogans, and we looked at a number of concepts. We convened focus groups to review the different concepts. The groups agreed on one logo to present. Doesn't mean that we necessarily agreed that it was the best thing, but we agreed on a logo to present. City councilors and senior leaders, though, favored a different approach in the end. They took a look at the logo and they just said the whole new logo change. Just said it doesn't feel like Albert Lea. It doesn't say Albert Lea. Couldn't quite put their finger on it, but they just knew, yes, it was nice and it was pretty, but it didn't seem to work. So we went back and we were like, okay, well, we're going to change this, give it one last shot. So we went to a refresh as opposed to a complete and total redo. And that's how it has led us to the concepts here today. So again, why refresh our logo? Does the 1977 logo best represent Albert Lea today? Is it simple? It's simple enough compared to maybe logos of the time, but is it simple compared to logos now? Not so much. Is it relevant? Well, as I said, you see a sailboat. Is that relevant to the community? Is it relevant in the time and the font that it represents? Again, everything from how the T and the and the way the E's are bent and the R goes into the T, and the A is slanted. This is 1970s play on a font. So it does say 70s here. Is it memorable? Yes, it is. And we'll get into that. Is it timeless? It's highly, highly debatable. Is it versatile? Yes. It is reasonably versatile. In comparison to a lot of logos, again, of its time. Now, there do become issues with the waves down below, depending upon the quality of the file, how big or small it gets, and how much bleeding and distortion goes into it. But overall, it can be made relatively versatile. Okay, well, I just kind of said our review of it. It's like, does it meet the new standards of simplicity? Not quite. Again, the sailboat, not intended or not, but is it relevant to the community? A lot of people that we've talked to seem to say, no, it isn't. Is it unique and memorable? Absolutely. It says 1977, so it's not really timeless, and it has some versatility. But is it capturing the people and giving the right message? Because again, part of it is that capture. Not the people who already live here, but the people who don't. So if you were to say, Albert Lea's a product on a shelf, we want it to say, you stand out and they can recognize it, you know, they can recognize it from a different aisle that Albert Lea's on the shelf. And not only is it there, but it looks like it's brand new. It doesn't look like it's been sitting there for 50 years. It's brand new, it's shiny, it's ready to go. So, refreshing our logo is a way to say we are looking to the future instead of the past. We're ready for a new identity as vibrant. As a vibrant community where people find lakes, land, and life. And that was one of the slogans that came from our original efforts the first time around. Benefits of a new logo. Placing outdated font and concepts of a picture to a more modern one, which again, I'll go into some examples later. We have the water tower, it's highly visible. So we do kind of have a little bit of a pressing deadline at this point to make a decision of going forward or staying the same. We could go for a review of inventory of forms, media, and more. Fresh start with our comprehensive planning efforts and aim for a more coordinated look with ALITA, Chamber of Commerce, CVB, Main Street. One of the things that was brought up, I think a number of times when we talked about the comprehensive plans, when we had the community meetings, in fact, probably when we had one of our largest ones, we were talking about threats to the community. And one of them that came up was people who are stuck looking in the rearview mirror instead of looking ahead at the road that they're traveling on. Looking too much to the past instead of looking to the future. That was a concern. And through that was the complaining and the negativity. And that was seen as a potential harm or threat to the ability for our community to grow. But what have other cities done? Again, when you're talking about certain concepts, yeah, our current logo is not as attempted to be as detailed as the city of Egan's was. That is just way too much detail to try to put into a logo. It makes it very difficult to be versatile. So they went to something a lot simpler. All capitalization of Egan, city of, was removed, And then they have, again, a picture of a tree, but a tree that's sort of within a circle, and they use very flowing, smooth shapes, sharp or non-sharp shapes, but very smooth shapes. Fairmont basically got rid of Fairmont and Convention and Visitors Bureau, just took the circle and made it more encapsulated, larger, and again, very simplistic, very flowing lines. And Winona went from, I guess you could say, 80s, 90s hair metal fonts. I don't know the best way to describe it. When I see that, I think, you know, Winger, I guess. I don't know the band Winger when I look at that font. But anyway, they went to just using the capitalization of W as their logo, and then just Winona, not City of. Again, all capitalization, more modern font. So when we're looking at these samples, we sort of create some criteria. We want to provide brand identity by remaining memorable and becoming more relevant. We want to make it simple enough to use in a broad range of sizes, making it versatile. We, if it cannot be timeless, we need to make it at least today or immediate future, because again, timelessness is a very hard thing to capture, to do. I think when people do create something that's timeless, it's honestly, in my opinion, it's more by accident, because you see so many products that you know, so many companies, so many organizations you know, they change their logo every 5, 10, 20 years, whatever it may be. And then also create an opportunity to coordinate marketing and branding with our partners that are involved in marketing and branding of the community. So here are a few samples of some rejected concepts. Now, I just want you to give them a quick look over, and so that way you can see the range in which we were working with here, a very broad range. This, amongst a couple other ones, just did not say Albert Lea. I think these were some of the concepts that were focus group-wise rejected relatively early. But we were trying to go for simplistic images. I think the one to the bottom and right was very abstract. And I think the other one was, it was simple, but it still, I guess to me, and someone said it kind of looks like a road sign. But again, I know these were all concepts and there's different ways to show them, but when you put it in this one, I think that's where it stood out that way. So again, it was very hard to find that thing that really felt like it captured the community. So we created an evolved criteria. Retain some of our elements. Avoid invalidating the current logo used in our metal work and the existing water towers and in other places throughout the community. Create more of a transition, an evolution, than an abrupt change. Create a more uniform look that as the city implements a new logo. So that way it doesn't, again, look so jarring. It doesn't look like it's completely out of place. Like, well, what's this truck from if that's not the same symbol as that, but if they're still able to easily transition, it may make things a lot easier. So our lessons learned in this process has been achieving 100% agreement with a logo concept is not to be expected. It will never be created. It is extremely difficult to get that level of agreement. And residents have expressed mixed feelings. When we first showed it a couple weeks ago, a number of people just had a little comment, so I like the L running into it. I don't like it running into it. I want it separated. I can hardly tell the difference, or, you know, I just don't want it to cost money, when they did have something negative to say. And then more recently, people are like, well, why are we changing it? And I think one of the biggest critiques I will answer here in a little bit. So there has been expressed mixed feelings, just like when we looked at the water tower. There was no consensus on that either. We had narrowed it down to 4. And then the local paper did a Facebook poll. And there was definitely no consensus to be had that way. Many may not understand the purpose of a logo and why it should change over time. I think that's one of the reasons why we were holding this meeting today and hoping there'd be more people to show up, is so that way we can talk a little bit about why logos do change. You see it all the time, but sometimes you never even notice it. I mean, the arches are going away at McDonald's. I don't know how many people noticed that, but they are. One of the most universal symbols for I don't know how many years. But even then, over time, that has also evolved slightly, ever so slightly, bit by bit. It's unique. Our current logo is very unique, and it is hard to design a new logo that maintains that uniqueness. I mean, it truly is a very unique piece. But one of the concepts that we came up with, or at least this is what it's gotten narrowed down to, there's a few more concepts, some where the waves were a little bit more off to, I guess, looking at the screen, it would be to the left. Sometimes the top wave was taken out. The font on Lakeland Life was maybe a bit smaller. We got rid of the, but we had City of Albert Lea at some point. But this has been a small evolution even since the last meeting, taking in some input from the council and other people from the public and just playing with it as we go along. And the second concept's very similar in the logo, slight changes in the font and the italicizedness of the Lakeland Life, and then a different font for Albert Lea right here. But it was requested, can we run the two L's together again and see what that looks like, even with a different font? Does that make it look different yet still hold true to certain elements of the past, previous design? If we were to implement a change, one, we'd want to trademark the design. We don't know if it was ever, the current one was ever trademarked, but we know that we'd want to do that because one of the things that we were going through is that we noticed is that when we were looking at different logos, we were noticing a lot of similarities with other logos. And so the last thing we want someone to do is go, hey, I like that one. I'm just going to take it for myself and completely undo every attempt at trying to adopt something that is truly unique. Immediate changes would be to website and social media. Again, that is just a little bit of staff time and labor. Electronic forms, again, some of our forms need to be gone through to make sure that they're current and up to date, or some forms just need to be put into electronic form and made to be fillable online. City seal in the council chambers would probably be the one most noticeable item that we'd actually physically replace if we were to make the change. Most elements over time as replacements are ordered, so we need new business cards at that point, then the new business cards will have the new logo. But meanwhile, they'll still stay with the old, or with the current. Vehicle signs, they'll stay with the current until time to get a new vehicle. Uniforms, same thing. So we would do it over time. There would be very few things that we would have to rapidly go in and make changes to. And like I said, with the idea of the refresh, we don't necessarily have to do it because we can still keep some of the history of the 1977 adopted logo in some of our artwork, in the downtown, in the ironwork, as an example, as one of the examples. Again, as we're seeking coordination, we did not do ourselves a very good favor with the color scheme of the Albert Lea and how the colors translated. Again, all of this is a slight work in progress. But as you can see, that even with the chamber, with the Lita, all that, the colors are not 100% coordinated. And even if we were to put ours up there, we'd probably find that our green is a more brighter lime green, and our blue is a slightly darker blue than what either the chamber or the Alita has done. And you can also see if the chamber, they took the sailboat image or the thought of image or what it may represent, and literally ran with it for their symbol. So,
aren't they looking at changing theirs?
Yes.
Okay.
But they were wanting to do it alongside with us, or That was the intent, and that is what they hope to do. So one last look at our current, at the what will be the more recent or most updated proposals to council. Again, I want to stress that the when it comes to this, we've only spent $750. And it so when it comes to the color quality, all of that, we have not asked the artists to sit here and go over every little super painstaking detail that you would eventually want in a final product, because we also know that there can be those calls for, hey, can you make a little change here, make a little tweak here? And the last thing we want them to do is to put all that effort in trying to make a final product and then keep editing it until we feel that we've gotten it close or where it needs to be. So I'd be happy to take any questions that anyone here in the audience has. If I repeat it, I'm repeating it for the microphone because we are recording this.
Do you have these here without the connected L?
No, I do not have the previous versions that were shown a couple weeks ago where the L's were separated. We certainly can put that back up, but I thought the instruction was that we wanted to see what that looked like with the different font. And we were still trying to show about two concepts. I think the picture, the logo-wise, I think was, there was a relative consensus that if it was to change, that was pretty much set. But it was the fonts, whether to connect the L's or not, was more in question, I think, from last meeting, if I'm not mistaken. I know four of you were there, so.
Yes, I took it as, and this is just me, but they wanted to see what it would look like. Not necessarily that's the way it was going to change. That's the way I understood it.
Oh, okay.
That doesn't mean.
So the first question was, again, about the L. Do we have one that's separated? And no, we do not right now. We probably can put one out there that does go back to showing the separation of the L. I know that that's actually in a previous post on the city's Facebook page about, I would say, 2 weeks ago. I believe that was in there. If people at home want to look at it, and then you had mentioned that you just, council wasn't necessarily set on combining it. It was just a matter of you wanted to have a look at the combination of the L with a different font.
That's what I understood.
Okay. Okay. Very good. Just want to make sure that that's clear, and anyone watching this will understand that.
Could you speak again to the Lake Land and Life tagline that came from some other entity that represents the city? Is that correct? That's why we're implementing that.
It didn't come from another entity. It when we first sat down and we were looking at the whole new logo, we were also looking at tagline. We were also looking at colors and fonts, generally speaking, and what they meant, in addition to just also the logo. One of the things that came up from that discussion was that the partnering agencies agreed that Lakeland Life seemed to, I think, across the board, summarize a lot of the different things that all the agencies are working towards or are stewards of or are an important part of what they do or the community in and of itself, a variety of different things. So like for CVB, we have events on the lake or around the lake, and we have events at the park, and it's all part of having a good life. And with the chamber, again, one major draw and major factor is the availability of our land and our and the lake here, and being able to have a good life as a business owner or as just someone, as a consumer. Again, for the city and for Lita, is something that we want to promote to people. Come here. We've got it. We've got what you need. We need you here. Because right now what we have is we don't have a jobs problem. We have a people problem. We need people of a certain age to come here to this community to fill the jobs. Because if we don't start getting it, our ability to grow will be greatly hampered. I mean, we've got one company that just started off, not even 6 months ago, and they're already looking at 100 people before the end of 2023. 100 employees in total. They're right now at about 40. So they're looking, so in 6 months, they grew from 0 to 40, and now they're looking at, in less than 12 months, going up to 100. They need people. We need people. We need people. We need places for them to live. We need people to want to come here. People are not moving to places just because a job is there. People are moving to places because they want to live there. They'll find the job, or they'll work from home.
I'd like to point out one of the design elements, and that's the white line. When we look at the original logo, this was pointed out to me earlier today, that it really forms an AL within the triangle. Here, not as much, but I think part of what Kathy told us last week was that's more designating of like trails and pathways,
yes,
which have become really important and are growing in Albert Lea.
Okay. Yes, if I could recap that here real quick. It was brought up that last presentation. We talked a little bit about the white strip that runs through. Previously, it was more of a sharp turn, and it was meant to designate the A and the L for Albert Lea within the triangle, but again, also kind of looked like a sailboat, even by the artist's own admission. But here we're taking that softer turn, which again, when you look at the previous logos where they have changed, again, they're going for softer lines and curves. But art is it's conceptual. It can be, people can perceive what they want out of art or out of symbols. And so the swoop mark could be a trail. It could be the idea of the flow of life. It could be a lot of things for a lot of people.
Subjective.
It's thank you. Subjective. It's very subjective to the individual. And but if we tried to make it too hard of a symbol, like this is a trail, or this is a that or another, or this is a tree, absolutely this is a tree, whatever it might be, I think at that point we start to lose that ability for people to look at it a little bit subjectively for themselves as well. And so that is a very nice element that, again, we wanted to pay homage to, but give it just that little bit of an update.
Yeah.
Yes.
A couple of things. Are we getting rid of the land between the lakes?
It was asked if we were getting rid of the land between the lakes. In the resolution that we have, basically it would be saying that our logo or our catchphrase, jingle, whatever you might want to say, is that it is going to be lake, land, life. So eventually that will be what is in there. Some people have said, are we truly the land between the lakes? Are we truly this? Are we truly... I know a lot of people have comments about it. I don't know how formally it was adopted. I know that it was very popular, I want to say, when we were also going through a lot of the blue zones.
Way before that.
Or even before that. Okay. So, part of this was a little bit of, again, the idea of if we were to move forward and to agree and to really simplify, again, create that very simple, dot, 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 that very simple figure, symbol, whatever it might be, the simpler the better, the easier it is to catch a broader group of people, and the easier it is to remember. So.
I've got a couple more comments. And this is coming from, I can't tell you guys how many emails and calls I've gotten and how many people I've spoken to about this. So another one of the concerns that I've been hearing and that I actually agree with is that it looks washed out.
And yes.
I really listened to people when they were talking to me about that, so I started to drive around town and pay attention to the logos on all the businesses that I was driving around seeing, and they're all very vibrant.
Yes.
So when I look at that, I'm like, I wouldn't mind seeing the new updated logo in the old colors.
And that is something that we are discussing. Again, when we gave the instructions to the designer, we had basically said, take our colors and see if they can be softened. We did not mean it. I don't think when we had given that instruction, this was the expectation. And it's not the expectation. So, right, but also what we were trying to go for was something that was still bright or bold, but still pulling in a more contemporary shade or color. Again, is what we were trying to see if it could be done, if it could be rendered easily. And we're finding the artist that's doing the work has been focused more on placement and font, and we just figured the color will probably be the last piece. And it is unfortunate because I think that's something that so many people online or in the community just instantly gravitated towards when they saw the current symbol to this one. It became very relevant or prevalent. Again, going back to the previous slides, again, next to these particular ones, again, it does look a little muted, a little faded. But if you were to take the current logo and compare it to the chamber, you would clearly see a difference in the color rendition between them. So, but by themselves, when you look at it, probably won't notice it as much. But when you put them right next to each other, it's even more noticeable. And I think that when we had that right next to it, it just really started to, and especially when we had translated it a couple different times over and then into social media, is that we realized that, yeah, these tones may not be as versatile as what we thought they might be. So again, versatility is grabbing attention, that's an important aspect of a logo. So that is something that we will be going over a bit more. So this is not a set color. I want to make sure that is clear to people who are very concerned about that. And you had, yes.
How about the blue lettering? I don't know what it would look like if you wanted to see it. Make that green instead of the blue. Would that be better than brought up?
It was asked about making the lettering green instead of blue. Originally, when we had City of above the Albert Lea, the City of was green. So that was mixed. And we kind of like the idea of doing it that way because the green kind of reaches the top of the picture and the blue sets to the bottom. And when we put them together, the Albert Lea was not quite as tall. It was shrunk down just a tiny bit. And the City of rested above it, making the green kind of line up towards the top and the blue across the bottom. And now that the City of has been taken out, we have not put in the option of making the lettering green.
I'd like to see what it would look like. But I know it's hard to do.
It's kind of like going to the right.
Yeah.
You know.
Put it together. It definitely needs to be brighter.
Yeah, I think everyone's in agreement about the brightness, that it does need to be made a bit brighter than what it currently is. And yeah.
One other thing I brought up at the planning meeting last week, or at the last council meeting, was about the Lakeland Life. And I had said, why can't it be Lakesland Life? And Kathy had indicated that, well, this has already been implemented in some of the other places and we want to tie into it. And I am really going to challenge that. Because I'm offended that it says lake, because I grew up playing on Goose Lake, Albert Lea Lake, Fountain Lake, Pickerel Lake, Dane Lake, White's Lake, right? So we don't just have a lake. We don't have events just on a lake. People fish on the lakes. And somebody said, well, if If you change lake to lakes, you have to change to lands and lives. No, you don't. Because I can wear a shirt and pants and, you know, a pair of shoes. Not everything has to be plural. I wear glasses. I don't wear a glass and a shirt. I wear glasses and a shirt, right? You can have lakes, land, and life. So that really, really bothers me, even just from a journalistic standpoint. It's not representing who we are.
Okay. If you weren't able to pick it up on the microphone, it was basically a comment or a concern about the idea of not having lake be plural and having, say, lakes, because there are many lakes within the community or the area. And that originally it said that that comment or the response 2 weeks ago was, well, it's already been adopted elsewhere as Lakeland Life, and that it's also singular throughout instead of plural. The English language is a funny thing in how we, you know, make certain rules about words and then don't follow them throughout.
Cool.
Well, you can... But our lake with inside the city limits complete in entirety is one lake. It is Fountain Lake. That is our main lake. That is our main activity lake.
I'm going
to
fight you on it.
And it has been, okay, but it has also been adopted. And again, we were trying to create some of that uniformity.
But we're the city. Don't let the tail wag the dog. We're the city. If the city says it's going to be lakes, the other ones can change to lakes. It really bothers me.
I'm sorry it bothers you.
This, well, I think we can have more. I think more of this discussion can happen at the council meeting. Right now, we're also doing this, and we are recording, so that way the public can also generally hear it. But yes, but your concern or your issues are been noted, and I made sure that they were recorded. So, all right. Anything else?
I have something. You know, if these are the two choices, if one of these two end up being that, when I look at those two, my eyes are drawn. They're easier to look at the upper one than the lower one. You know what I mean? As far as the Albert Lea's concerned.
You mean the Futura font as opposed to the other one, I cannot remember the name of right now.
It's smoother. It just feels, okay. I think, if you're talking timeless, I think that's more timeless than the lettering on the bottom. That's just my opinion, of course.
Yes. And in that timelessness, when we did take, this font is actually the same font. The upper left font, the Futura font, is very similar or exactly the same as the previous font. It's just the liberties that were taken with that font that originally had things like the E twisted and the R and the T running into each other and the A slanted up against the L. Those liberties with the font were removed. And just by simply doing that, that seemed to change a statement of when it was made and has become, I think, as you had mentioned, yes, it does seem to be closer to being a bit more timeless than as opposed to the original font, which again, very creative, but also very symbolic of the time in which it was created.
For the people that watch this online later, could you speak to again the cost so far, and if there's any estimates on, because that's a big comment we get a lot, obviously.
Okay.
You know, on what it's going to cost.
Okay. The
process continues and completes.
The question was, can I comment a little bit on the cost? The current refresh that you're looking at, we have spent $750, and then we have another $750 to finish it up once we come up with a final product, which will have basically things like final adaptation or final changes to color, size, certain placements, and font. We will have all of that. Again, that $750 we were looking at was just to look at a refresh concept. Previously to that, we had spent I want to say between the city spent the money, but it was in conjunction working with Alita, CVB, Chamber, and Main Street. So we were all sitting there together going through the process. And I believe that original process where we're looking at what other communities have done for their changes, going through that, going through some of the ideas or theories about some of the changes and the simplicity of it, or creating something simplistic, all of that cost us right around $2,000. Now, I have seen and heard of communities blow through $50,000 or $100,000 on marketing upgrades. So we are not doing that. So if people are thinking in their head the horror stories they hear about, you know, misappropriation of you know, wild spending on a very simple logo change or rebranding, that is not what we are doing here today. We were very conscientious of the taxpayers' money, did not want to spend a ton of money on an exercise that we were also ourselves uncertain if it would even bear any fruit to even show to the council or to eventually to the public, you know. And so we did not want to go through a process like that and spend that kind of money. So we were very conscientious, and I want to make sure people know that. When it comes to implementation, again, it's going to be, other than probably the seal behind the council chambers, it's going to be the free stuff first, the stuff that we got to go through and do anyway.
So the original $2,000 was basically spent back when the water tower and the new logo ideas were being bandied about. Is that correct?
Between this refresh concept and the water tower, where we sat down more as a group and did more of the focus groups and kind of, quite frankly, hit some bumps in the road and needed some guidance on how to get through all of that. Yes.
For the record, there is one sign in Albert Lea that will definitely need to be refreshed. It should have been refreshed 10, 15 years ago, maybe 20 years ago. You know where it's at?
Over by Skyline Mall?
Yes.
Yes. And again, that's something that we know we need to do, and it's like, are we going to refresh it with the current logo we've got right now, or are we gonna? So we were actually looking at doing that a little while ago, but we kept holding off because we hadn't fully answered this yet. So
Marv had a lot to do with placing that sign there, so it'd be kind of like a memorial to him, and I think we should have a memorial to Marv because he did a lot for the city. He wouldn't object to some of this, I'm sure. But the two on the side, I'm sure he wouldn't object to changing it a little bit. But keep it bright. Keep it so it's there, so it's very visible and very bright.
Okay. So in case that was not picked up by the microphones, I just want to make sure I'm kind of capturing this or paraphrasing this, that yes, we definitely need to change the sign or update the sign over at the Skyline Mall. And it would be your preference to find some way to memorialize Marv in doing this process, both for what he contributed in the symbol and also in what he has done, you know, sitting on the council as mayor and a member of the community. And then you do not feel that he would have an objection necessarily to a few of these changes, except he would just want to see it a bit more vibrant in color.
Right.
Okay,
right.
Thank you. I just want to make sure I recap that.
More vibrant.
Very good. Well, if it's nothing else, we're getting close to...
I just want to go on record to say that the feedback that I've had from people that have gotten hold of me, it's... they don't want to see a change. I think I may have one that is okay with it, but the other ones, it's kind of surprising. I mean, the people that don't want to change. And I haven't talked to some of them personally, which I'm going to get back to, and just try to find out why they don't want to change. change, if it was just, you know what I'm saying, and try to explain to them a little bit more.
Basically, the comment was that a lot of people have approached Councilmember Baker and have expressed that they do not wish to have it changed, but have not really had a chance to go through and find out why, whether it's because they think it's going to cost, whether or not it's just because the colors aren't as vibrant as they like, or whether it's just completely they just don't want to change at all. But one thing I would say to those people that are who look at this and just like, oh, I just don't want to change it. Every organization, every company that has a logo, that uses a logo, that's trying to market themselves, makes changes one way or another. And, some companies go through or some organizations go through and spend, hundreds and thousands or millions of dollars sometimes to go through and do it. And we're trying to do it here for a couple thousand bucks is what we're trying to do here. And in part, it's going to take a little bit of time. It's going to be a little painful. But at the end of the day, though, there will have to be a decision that has to be made. And it will be coming from the council like it was in 1977. I don't know how much debate there necessarily was. One story I was told was that it just sort of appeared before council and they voted on it. I don't know if that's quite exactly how it happened, or it might be a simplification of the process. But in the end, it still does come from the council. We'll have to make a decision. And we do have to have a decision by no later than March 13th. There will be a resolution available for council if council feels that they have gotten the input and feel comfortable moving forward at that point on the 27th, on Monday. They certainly will have the opportunity to vote on that, or they will be able to wait another 2 weeks and make a decision at that point. So, yes, one last. Okay.
The other thing is we're kind of doing a historic thing downtown in honor or in memory of Mark Longin, that would be a good thing for the city to come to the light.
Okay. And I'm sorry, what was your first name?
Jane.
Jane here has expressed that she wishes the logo to stay the same. She does see a sailboat with the current logo, but with the new one, she sees something more represents maybe a religious symbol, I believe you put how you put it, and that you really feel like it might be a good to honor Marv and honor our history by keeping the logo the same. Does that about sum it up? Okay. All right. Thank you.
Okay. Lake, now I live by Bowen Lake, and we're around Albert Lea. It's the same time.
Okay.
Every lake in the area is touched by the city limits of Albert Lea. Every lake. White's Lake, Lake Chapel out there, that's touched by it at least three sides. Goose Lake, around here, that was built up kind of around it. You got Dane Lake, and that's built completely around. Albert Lea Lake, the west half of it, all the way out to Dawn Acres. And then you got Fountain Lake. I think that's all of it.
Yeah. So again, some of it.
Picker Lake with the cold now. That is in.
Yep.
Along the edge.
So the comment was again for the in support of the more plural statement about lakes Lakeland Life, not Lakeland Life. Okay. Well, thank you, everyone, for attending and giving me about 55 minutes of your time. I appreciate it. To everyone that watched at home, thank you for watching. And we'll continue the discussion. Thanks.